Hi everyone, this is Jeffrey from Artifacts. In today's lesson, we will learn how to marble the fantasy pattern. Before we begin, here are some of the things you will need. About a tablespoon of carrageenan powder, marbling paints, a tray, some bamboo skewers, a pipette, and last but not least, several sheets of alum-coated papers. Let's start by pouring in the carrageenan. Carrageenan is used to thicken the water. This solution is also known as the marbling size. It's best to prepare it at least a day before you start marbling. Use a stick to stir the marbling bath gently. Then, place a sheet of newsprint. Let it soak for a while and skim the surface. Skimming helps to remove bubbles and any kind of skin that may have formed so the paints can spread out nicely on the surface. Ready? Let's start marbling. You can use the paints directly from the squeeze bottle, or, if you prefer, uncap the bottle and insert a skewer to get the paint on the tip. This will help control the amount of paint you use. We will start by putting several drops of paint on the marbling bath. Do this until you gradually cover the entire surface. This first layer will become the base color, something like a background. We'll add some circles over the background. Here, you see cyan or blue circles being added. Try not to make the circles too big. Now we'll put white dots over each of the cyan circles. Then, add some yellow over the white. Continue with this process. Here, we placed red dots over the yellow. Let's finish with some violet or purple dots. Here comes the fun part. We're going to comb some zigzag patterns. With a clean stick, start combing with a zigzag motion, starting at the top and moving from side to side downwards. Move the stick gently as you comb the zigzag pattern. Next, we will comb up and down, perpendicular to the previous strokes. Then, gradually venture into freestyle, wavy strokes, such as fluid S curves and figure eights. Just be careful not to overdo the combing. The lines should remain bold and distinct. We are ready to transfer our marbled design onto paper. Something important to note here. One side of the paper has a pencil marking across. Make sure you do not print on this side. Use the clean side instead, which has been treated with alum. Alum is a mordant which helps the paint to bind to the paper. Place the clean side face down. Pat the paper all over to ensure the paper is in full contact with the marbled pattern. Lift the paper gently, peeling it off slowly from the surface. A mesmerizing, colorful fantasy pattern. Next, we will rinse the excess carrageenan from the paper. Some people skip this step altogether and proceed to dry the paper. It's alright if you decide to skip the rinsing, but sometimes you may notice excess paint bleeding all over the paper. So it's best you rinse the paper for a crisp, clean print. You can leave the marbled paper on a clothesline to dry. Let's go over to clean the marbling residue. Lay a sheet of newsprint over the marbling size and skim the surface, just like you did in the beginning. Repeat this until the surface is free from any residual paints. Congratulations for your attempt at the fantasy pattern. I hope you've enjoyed the process. Try the fantasy in your own color scheme. Have fun, and I'll see you again in the next lesson. Bye!